savings for the company. And this is what is, you know, the combined approach, the combined way of improving the effectiveness and improving the efficiency is today given a different names, fancy names, and one of the name is operational excellence, which we are trying to, you know, understand in this program. So this is how, you know, the Six Sigma evolved from the company called Motorola. Right, done. And now coming to the lean. What is lean? Lean is all about efficiency. How the efficiency, you know, improves? Efficiency improves if you focus on what is required. If you focus on what is required and minimize doing things which are not required, your process will become lean. So what is lean? Focus on what is required and reduce doing the activities that are not required, right? So the activities that are not required are called as waste. Do you understand what is waste? Any activity that is not required to achieve the effectiveness, to achieve the desired effectiveness, they're all called non-value adding activities. They're all called wasteful activities. Identify them, eliminate them. Now your process is lean. Do you understand? Now your process is lean. She keeps saying yes or no, pa. Please, one or few of you, when I come to a question tag, when you understand, because these are all not, you know, simple things which a student can understand. I always do this program only for, you know, the top management. You are not even part of the company now, but I still want you to understand all these things. So you need to let me know whether, you know, the language is convenient to you or the terminologies are convenient to you. I get to understand only when you say yes or no. Already you are hiding your face. And now if you keep silence, then my job now will be very difficult. So all wasteful activities, otherwise called non-value adding activities, are eliminated. If I eliminate, my process will reach a state that is called lean. Or we call it, you call it future state, or you call it lean. That means the lead time will come down. The lead time will come down. So identify and eliminate all activities that are waste. Focus on optimal flow throughout the process. Focus on optimal flow throughout the process. Optimal flow means pull. Focus on creating value for customers. Focus on creating value for customer. Don't focus on unnecessary activities. Rather, focus on the necessary activities, right? If you drive a car in a traffic environment, you can't drive conveniently, and at the same time your car cannot perform better. But what lean is telling, why are you driving a car here? You drive here, the environment is much clean. Why it is clean? I removed all the wasteful activities, all the unnecessary activities I removed, and now I can drive comfortably. At the same time, my car performance can be much, 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 much better. This is the impact lean can make, right? So lean philosophy comes with lot of tools and techniques. Lean philosophy comes with lot of tools and techniques. And one of the tool is Kaizen. One of the tool is Kaizen. Kaizen is nothing but doing small, small improvement activities in a company. Kaizen is doing small, small improvement activities in a company, right? If I do small, small improvement activities, you know what happens? Lot of wasteful activities will vanish. I do small, small improvement, what will happen? The wasteful activities will improve. The Kaizen is a Japanese word where K stands for change, Gen stands for better. K stands for change and Zen stands for better. Changing for the betterment, right? So, in other words, it is called as continuous improvement. So in order to help you understand what is Kaizen, I want to do a small activity with all of you. And now, in order to do the activity, you all need to come on video, and then you need a pen, and then you need some notepad, right? Or a paper. Do you all have a pen and a paper, or pen and a notepad? Right? Do you have?
Yes, sir.
Yes, please. Please do come on video. we will do an activity. I will explain what we are going to do. You need a pen and a pad or a paper. I will show certain numbers and certain symbols on the screen. See, do you want to participate? I've been telling some instruction and nobody is, you know, responding. We are going to do an activity. You need to come on video, then I will show something on the screen.
Sir?
Yes.
So my camera isn't working, sir, in my mobile.
Okay, well, see, 1 or 2% not, you know, cooperating is not a problem. 1 or 2%.
And sir, at my place, there is no any current supply. Like, that's only what? Few utilities are working, like my fan and running on
solar. See, I understand. 1 or 2 people not cooperating is not never a problem. I don't want everybody to respond to all my, you know, requests. I want few people at least, you know, to participate, and absolute zero participation and zero result. So few people need to participate. Actually, everybody have to participate, but then, you know, you have a lot of reasons, so which I don't have control over that, which only you can control. Your mic is not working and your camera is not working. We are not doing a video shoot, or we are not doing a cultural program here. We are doing just, you know, attending a meeting. An ordinary camera, ordinary mic are good enough, right? We are not taking, you know, a full picture to have, you know, adequate sounding system, adequate camera, high definition camera. Nothing is required. Your ordinary mobile camera is fine. So nobody would like to participate? I could see Balaji coming forward and Amit Kumar, and who else? Only 2 people. See, I've been telling you everything, but you're not learning. Right, I could see 3 or 4 people. That's fine. So at least with that motivation, I will move forward. What I will do is, I keep me on the video, right? Because I want to understand that you follow my instruction during the activity. See, there are certain numbers and certain symbols I am going to see on my screen. What is that I am going to see? I am going to show some numbers and some symbols. I will show it exactly for 45 seconds. I will show it exactly for 45 seconds. What you need to do is, you just have to memorize. I don't want you to write. What I want you to do, I want you to memorize. Is that instruction clear? Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So we go for it, the 45 seconds. Your time starts now. Right, so 45 seconds was over. Now what I do is, I will give you some time so that you can, you know, reproduce the number and symbols in your notepad now, and tell me how much time you require. Can you make a suggestion?
So on, show it again, sir, please.
Come again.
Show it again, sir, please.
No, that is over. I have already given the time. Now don't worry. Whatever you remember, you write. You don't have to write everything. And now tell me how much time you may require to reproduce. Let us understand your effectiveness as well as your efficiency. Tell me. So come on, suggest. Can I give you same 45 seconds for reproducing it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So your time starts now. I have switched on the stopwatch. Your time starts now. You can write down the number and the symbol. If you are able to match the number and the symbol, you get one mark. Now there are 10 such a thing. Your time starts now. Go ahead. Write down the numbers and the symbol in the same order. Right. In fact, I have given you 1 minute fully. All of you can stop writing, but I could see only 4 people, interacting with me. And now, let us do a self-assessment. I'll show you the same numbers and symbols once again. Now you can cross-verify. Now cross-verify, do a self-evaluation, and tell me how much score you got?
Eight, sir.
So Amit Kumar got 8. And then others, who else got 8?
I also got eight.
Austin David got 8. Then Balaji, what is your score?
8, sir.
Balaji 7. Also got 8. Abdul Rahman?
6, sir. Like the orders 6. Are different. The number, it should match with exactly with that.
Yes, correct. Anyway, don't worry. 6. Others?
7, sir.
7. And how about
7,
others?
7, sir.
Okay, 7.
Sir, I'm 6.
So 7, sir.
7. So people have got 6, 7, and 7, 8 sir. Marks. What is expectation? 10 out of 10, am I right?
Yes, sir.
If you got 10 out of 10, then you are fully effective. If you got 10 out of 10, you are effective. But none of you got 10 out of 10. That means what is the effectiveness? None of us got 10 out of 10. Those who got 8, your effectiveness is 80%. Those who got 6, your effectiveness is 60%. Those who got 3, your effectiveness is 30%. We'll talk about efficiency. Right? Well, what is efficiency here? How much time you spent to memorize? How much time you spent?
45 seconds, sir.
45 seconds. And to reproduce, how much time you took?
1 minute, sir.
1 minute. So 45 seconds plus 60 seconds, totally 105 seconds. 105 seconds you spent to achieve the effectiveness of 60%. To achieve the effectiveness of 80%. So you have problem with respect to effectiveness, very clear, because 100% is what customer wants. You have efficiency problem also, because I feel that 105 seconds is too high for the problem given to you. Am I correct? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
105 seconds is too high. You can be more efficient. Right? Let us prove that. So what we do is, I want you to do the activity once again. I will show the number, but this time I am not going to show the number for 45 seconds. I will show it only for 30 seconds. Is it okay? I will show it only for 30 seconds. And then for writing down, I will give you only 30 seconds. So what is the total time you have?
1 minute.
1 minute, 60 seconds. I want to see an improvement in effectiveness as well as improvement in efficiency. Improvement in effectiveness means all of you should score high mark, number one. Will it happen? Will it happen or not?
High chances, sir.
It should happen. I want you to be super efficient. Earlier I gave you 105 seconds. Now I am giving you 60 seconds only. If you achieve it, your efficiency has increased, your effectiveness has increased. Shall we try it? Yes?
Yes, sir.
So once again, I switch on the stopwatch. Your time starts now. The same number and same symbol, but in a different style. Yes, the time over. And now I said, you know, I will give another 30 seconds. I give another 30 seconds. So go for it. You can start writing now. 30 seconds now. Yes, stop writing. Now you can check and you can do a self-assessment and tell me your score.
How much? 10 of 10, sir.
Oh, 10 out of 10. Balaji got 10 out of 10. Amit got 10 out of 10. How about others?
10, sir.
You also got 10. Very good. How about the remaining?
10, sir. Sir, 10, sir. Answer.
That means your effectiveness has improved. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Your efficiency also improved. Am I correct or not? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Your effectiveness improved. That means there are no defect. All got 10 out of 10. Your efficiency has improved because you consumed less time. Can you make the same thing happen in a workplace, work environment? That is called Kaizen. What is that called? Kaizen. So what we did, the same number, same symbol, but result is different. How? We made the work easier. What is the work here? You memorize. What is the work here? You retrieve the memory. You memorized and then you retrieved it. And memorizing was made easier because of the pattern in the arrangement. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Memorizing was made easier because of the pattern in the number. If you bring a pattern, some kind of orderliness, storing becomes easier. If storage becomes easier, retrieval becomes much more easier. You need to apply this principle in workplace. Make all the storage activities, make all the retrieval activities easier for the employees. If you make it easier for the employees, what will happen to the company? The effectiveness will improve. The efficiency will improve. And such things are called Kaizen. And Kaizen is continuous improvement because you can keep on improving. Let me go to the next level of Kaizen. Do you see some numbers and symbols again? Are they same? Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now tell me the new pattern. Does it require 30 seconds for memory?
No, sir.
No, how sir, much, not.
How much time required?
Span of seconds, maybe 2.
5 seconds, right. And for retrieval, for writing down, how much time you may require?
10 seconds.
So total work is getting completed in 15 seconds. Do you have the confidence to get 10 out of 10?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The effectiveness is going close to 100% when we make the storage and retrieval easier. Storage is a non-value-adding activity. Storage is a non-value-adding activity. Retrieval is a non-value-adding activity. Right? What the value-adding activity is what you are writing in the paper. Because that only that the customer can see. Similarly, in a workplace, you simplify the storage activity, you simplify the retrieval activity, and the result of the such a process will have maximum effectiveness and maximum efficiency. This is called Kaizen. Do you all understand what is Kaizen? Kaizen is eliminating non-value-adding activities. Kaizen is simplifying the work. You simplify the work and amplify your result. Small, small improvements involving every department and every employee in your organization is called Kaizen. It is key to your efficiency. And examples, logically positioning the tools and material. We are positioning the tools and materials logically. We make work easier to the employee and make the work environment comfortable to the employees. Provide assisting devices and adjustable work table to workers. Create mistake proofing system. These are all called what? Kaizen. And now let us understand how, what Kaizen will mean in a factory environment, right? So this video will help you to understand what is Kaizen. Small, small improvement. You make small, small improvement in such a way that people at all level, right? Whether he is a skilled employee or a semi-skilled work employee or an unskilled employee, whether he is an employee with some disabilities, he can work better and he can produce better, right? So let me play the video.
Visitors to factories in Japan often remark how carefully and neatly.
Seven waste. We'll discuss the seven waste probably in the upcoming modules. And you can remember them using the word Timwood, where T means transportation waste, I means inventory waste, M means motion waste, W means waiting waste, O is overproduction, another O is over processing, D means defects. These are all the seven waste. And then there is a tool called 5S. There is a tool called Kaizen. What is Kaizen? Continuous improvement. Small, small changes. Enhancing our efficiency. Thereby, effectiveness also will improve. You have lively seen, right? 5S is organizing the workplace in a neat manner, in an easy to work manner. So what will happen? People will be motivated to produce results. So each S stands like this. First S is sort. Second, it is set in order. Third S is shine. Fourth one is standardize. And the fifth one is sustain. And each and every S has got will produce a significant impact and improvement in your results, right? So we'll discuss that. And then there is a tool called SMED. SMED stands for single minute exchange of dice. It is a tool that can reduce the changeover time. And then there is a tool called Kanban. Kanban is nothing but a signal, a trigger. Some kind of signal is required that will make your system a pull system. If there is a demand, an item is produced. If there is no demand, no item is produced. So such a system is called Kanban. We'll discuss that. And then VSM. VSM means value stream mapping. What is happening in my company? I will create a process flow chart. I map all the activities, the time taken by each activity, the number of people involved, the amount of material consumed. Everything is documented from the moment raw material is received till the finished product is supplied to my customer. Such a diagram is called what? Value stream mapping. And then, there is another tool called TPM. TPM means total productive maintenance. What is it called? Total productive maintenance. How can I upkeep my equipments, machineries, everything in a ready to work condition? Do you know there are a lot of maintenance activity that happens in a company, because every equipment, you know, is costing a good money for the company, and so all the equipments have to be, you know, kept in a working condition. There are certain preventive maintenance, you know, schedules, and sometimes corrective maintenance takes place. How can you take care of the maintenance in a preventive manner? Thereby, there is no necessity for corrective maintenance. Right? That is called TPM. And then 3M. 3M means Muda, Mura, and Muri. Muda means any waste. How many waste are there in any company, in any process?
Seven.
There are seven types of waste are there. You must be able to see all the seven waste and eliminate them. The equivalent Japanese word for waste is Muda. You must eliminate all the Mudas. And then there are two more Japanese words, Mura and Muri. Mura means unevenness. Muri means overburden. What is overburden? If you stress a resource more than its capacity. For example, no, let's say you have a crane. The capacity is 2 tons. Can I use a 2-ton crane to lift a 2.5 tons load? Can I do it?
No, sir.
What will happen? A failure will happen. The crane also will get damaged. The 2-ton workpiece also will get damaged. So that means you are overburdening your resource. That is called Muri. And why Muri is happening? Because there is Muda. Because there is Mura. What is Mura? Unevenness. Unevenness means you are loading only certain resources, but many, many other resources are idle. For example, no, I have 3 machines. I always use machine number 1, and machine number 2 is at rest. Machine number 3 is also at rest. Now what happened? At some point of time, machine number 1 will undergo wear and tear very fast. And moreover, since I don't use all the 3 machines together, my customer has to wait for a longer period of time. This is called, you know, Mura. How many of you understand Mura? How many of you understand unevenness? Do you understand what is unevenness? Purida Lepa, do you all understand what is unevenness? When I have 3 machines, when I want to produce 300 products, I must use all the 3 machines. Produce 100 from machine number 1, 100 from machine number 2, and 100 from machine number 3. I can always, you know, produce all 300 from one single machine. When I produce all 300 from single machine, will I consume more time? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
I'll take more time, so my customer has to wait a longer time. When I make my customer wait longer time, probably next time he may not come to me. Is it logical?
Yes, sir.
So we must always try to eliminate the waste, try to eliminate the unevenness, and try to eliminate the overburdening of resources from any factory environment. If you learn to use all these tools, your factory will be super efficient. And it is now ready to produce world-class products. Producing world-class products is effectiveness. And the readiness for effectiveness happens when you remove these things, waste, unevenness, and overburdening. Do you all understand the purpose of lean? Do you want to learn all these tools? Should I teach you or not? All these tools. Do you want to learn this? Solungaba, do you think this will be helpful, learning all the tools?
Yes, sir.
But these are not simple things. Even people who are working in the company, you know, they struggle a lot to implement all these things, to learn and then implement all these things. And if you want to learn, you need to participate a lot, right? So I really, you know, struggle in enabling all of you to understand all these things. In fact, I am burdening myself to make all these things easily understandable. But if you can help me with some kinds of participation, then I don't have to put this much effort to cover all these things for you. I can easily do it, right? So now, again, we are talking about the foundation of Toyota. The foundation of Toyota is